all Ryerson wet lab personnel handling hazardous chemicals are required to do so in a safe manner. In this video, people working in a laboratory, studio, or workshop are shown how they can safely handle chemicals. All hazardous chemicals are identifiable using the WMIS 2015 system. All chemicals found in a laboratory must be equipped with either a supplier label, which contains more detailed information, or a workplace label, which should contain the minimum safety information for a chemical-specific use within the workplace. Both of these labels inform the chemical user about hazards and/or risks associated with the chemical and provide instructions on how to safely handle and store the chemical. All lab chemicals must also be equipped with a safety data sheet, or SDS, which is an information sheet that provides even further information about the chemical. SDSs are usually shipped with a package when you order your chemicals. You can also obtain SDS online via the HECMET system, Higher Education Cooperative for Hazardous Materials Tracking. You may access HECMET using either Vertaire or ChemWatch. To access the Vertaire online inventory, use your lab's account login information. In Vertaire, you can view SDS as well as barcode information, CAS numbers, location, and quantity of each of the chemicals found in your space. To obtain a Vertaire user account, please contact the Environmental Health and Safety Office. The other method of obtaining and viewing SDS is by viewing the ChemWatch website. ChemWatch is an international chemical management software affiliated to HECMET. This site will enable you to print out SDS labels of different sizes. All Ryerson labs, studios, and workshops have these signs posted outside the entrance to indicate the type of laboratory that one is about to enter. Please be familiar with the signage and ensure that you're aware of the types of hazards found inside, what WMIS hazard classes are present, and the minimal personal protective equipment, or PPE, that is required to work or enter the laboratory. The signage will also describe any special precautions for entry or exit that need to be followed. Under the required training, you'll see a list of training that you must complete if you're planning to work in the lab. An emergency contact will also be posted, and it's usually either the PI or a technical officer's contact information. Before handling hazardous chemicals, ensure the appropriate personal protective equipment is worn. Given the various hazard levels associated with chemicals at Ryerson, the following PPEs should be utilized at all times when in the lab: a lab coat which covers the entire body, and all clothes. Your lab coat should be worn at all times when in the laboratory. After lab work, each coat should be stored in an easily accessible location in the lab if you're working in a research lab. The coat should never be hung with street clothes or other non-lab related objects or items. The lab coat must not be worn outside of the lab. Proper footwear should be worn at all times when in the lab. Flats or flip-flops must never be worn. The shoes you wear must have full foot coverage with good gripping, solid, flat soles, or reasonably sized heels. Safety glasses are used because they're made of unbreakable lenses of plastic or tempered glass designed for light to moderate work. Goggles are used when the work involves significant risk of splash of chemicals or projectiles and can be worn over prescription glasses. Regular prescription glasses should never be used as the only protection for your eyes. Instead, wear safety glasses or goggles over the prescription glasses. The purpose of these glasses is to protect against risk of flying objects, dust particles, splashes of hazardous materials, or from harmful rays. Face shields are used when the work involves significant risk of splash on face or possible explosions and protects the face adequately, however, not the eyes. Gloves protect against risk of cuts, abrasions, burns, or exposure to hazardous materials. Ensure the use of the appropriate chemical-resistant gloves when handling lab chemicals. Before putting on gloves, remove all dangling jewelry. Ensure you do not use gloves that have a hole or tear. Do not reuse or reapply disposable gloves. Change gloves frequently throughout the course of the workday. Gloves may tear or develop a hole through normal wear and usage. Strict attention must be paid when removing gloves so that the outer surface of the glove does not come into contact with exposed skin. Remove gloves by slowly pulling them down, one at a time, and turning them inside out. Dispose of gloves in a designated biohazard container or receptacle if required. For lab personnel with long hair, ensure it is restrained by having it tied up. Also, when handling hazardous lab chemicals, ensure no dangling jewelry is worn. The ultimate purpose of wearing the appropriate personal protective equipment is to minimize lab workers' possible exposure to chemical hazards and risks as much as possible. To avoid the occurrence of accidents, all chemicals must be properly stored in appropriate locations. Cabinets are used for flammables, acids, and bases. Always keep the heavy chemicals on bottom shelves and the lighter chemicals on upper shelves. For easy reaching purposes, do not store the chemicals too high up on the shelf. Avoid storing too many chemicals on one shelf. For best practice, please ensure that the shelves have a lip to prevent items from sliding off. Fireproof refrigerators may be used to store chemicals depending on their properties. Ensure that all chemicals are stored according to their hazard classes, such as flammables being stored with flammables, acids with acids, and bases with bases. Use Ryerson's Chemicals Incompatibility Table to identify which of your chemicals can be stored together. Always be careful to segregate the chemicals in their storage areas according to their compatibility. Avoid storing chemicals on the floor to prevent the occurrence of spills if chemicals are accidentally knocked over or kicked. Also, minimize storing chemicals on lab benches, which should only be used for storage when chemicals are ready to be handled or utilized. Refrain from using the fume hood as a storage area. For specific storage instructions, please always refer to the information provided in safety data sheets. To ensure the chemical products are moved from place to place within the facility in a safe manner, and to reduce the risk of spills or other incidents, the following procedures should be followed. Transportation of hazardous bottles should always be done using a secondary container or equipment, such as a cart, bucket, or tray. Do not carry chemicals using only your hands. Only freight elevators should be used when transporting hazardous materials from one floor to another. When transporting compressed gas cylinders, please use the appropriate cylinder cart. You can find a cylinder cart in the Ryerson University Analytical Center if you don't have one in your lab. Ensure that you have taken the e-learning training on compressed gas cylinders, as this will provide you with further transportation details of compressed gas cylinders. Chemical lab work always generates waste, most of which is generally hazardous and must be handled safely. Ensure your chemical waste is collected in the appropriate waste containers. However, keep in mind not to put incompatible chemicals in the same container. Use another container if necessary. Please ensure that you label your waste as you fill containers. Every time you put waste in the container, fill out the label with the list of chemicals inside the container. The container must be kept closed at all times to minimize exposure. For the filled waste container to be picked up by the hazardous waste company, a request for waste pickup must be made by filling out the online submission form. The form can be found on the Environmental Health and Safety website. Also, if your bottles containing a chemical had a Ryerson barcode, remember to remove or write down the barcode number and fill out the barcode return form on the Environmental Health and Safety website. Every other week, the waste pickup company will visit each lab that filled out the online form in order to pick up their chemical waste. To ensure that your chemical waste will be picked up, make sure you have requested a pickup online by the deadline and have fully labeled the waste container with all the required information. The broken glass waste container located in each laboratory should be utilized to dispose of glass. Never pick up chemical broken glass containers with your bare hands. Have gloves on and use a tong or dustpan to pick them up for disposal. There are two types of chemical spills that can happen in any lab. The first is a major spill, which is characterized as being high in quantity and/or very hazardous in nature, or the size and/or type of material make these spills an immediate threat to health and safety of lab staff, other personnel, or the environment. The second is minor spills, which can be characterized as small in quantity and/or not too hazardous in nature, or the size and/or type of material are not an immediate threat to the health and safety of lab staff, other personnel, or the environment. If you're faced with a minor spill, the expectation at Ryerson is that you're qualified to clean it up. However, never assume the nature of the spill unless you were involved. Each lab that has chemical hazards is equipped with a universal spill kit. This kit is mounted to the wall in a visible area. Each spill kit contains a minimum of 5 universal pads, 2 polyethylene bags, 1 pair of goggles, 1 pair of gloves, 1 scrub pad, 1 hazardous waste label, 1 pair of tongs, 1 scoop and brush, 1 marker or pen, and 5 incident report papers. Staff must ensure this kit is fully stocked and easily accessible. Before cleaning up any spills, ensure you've received the proper training. You may contact the Environmental Health and Safety Office for training on how to use the kit and its materials. Always review safety data sheets of the spilled material, if it is known, prior to entering the spill area. If the spill is minor, then you should be able to clean it up yourself. Wear personal protective equipment, including safety goggles, gloves, and a long-sleeve lab coat during cleanup. Confine the spill to a small area by using the absorbent pad from your spill kit to absorb spilled materials. When all liquid is absorbed, pick up the materials with a broom and dustpan. For any larger pieces of glass, use a pair of tongs. Place the saturated absorbent and broken glass in the solid waste container or in the polyethylene bag. Label the container or bag with the hazardous waste info and include it in the next hazardous waste collection. Clean the spill area with soap and water. Always clean from the outside towards the center of a spill. For the spill kit to be ready when it's needed next, replenish the supplies as soon as possible by using the contact information provided in the spill kit. Fill out an incident report form and submit a copy to the Environmental Health and Safety Office and to your supervisor. If the spill is large, or if you're unsure how to classify it, immediately call Ryerson Security by dialing 80. In the event of a major spill, avoid breathing vapors. Quickly identify the spilled material if you can do so safely, based on knowledge of chemicals and lab conditions at the time of the spill. Block drains by throwing some absorbing material on the spill from your spill kit. If the spill involves a flammable liquid, turn off all ignition sources if you can do so safely. Make sure all fume hoods are on. Alert people in the area and evacuate, closing all doors. Lock doors and post warning signs. Eyewash stations and safety showers are safety devices that are utilized in emergency situations that involve chemical splashing on lab personnel. They should be located in a clearly visible area of the laboratory. If a chemical splash occurs on someone's face or eyes, make sure they remove safety glasses and locate the emergency eyewash station. Immediately turn on the eyewash station by pushing the lever beside it. Flush the eyes and your face for 15 to 20 minutes. During the flushing, hold your eyes open. Gently rotate the eyeballs from left to right and up and down to remove contamination from all areas of your eyes. If you have contacts, take them out during the flushing, as you don't want to delay the flushing. If the spill occurred on the body, make sure to remove the lab coat and locate the safety shower. Immediately flush the affected body area with water for 15 to 20 minutes. Use an available clean lab coat to cover yourself afterwards. In both cases, consult with a medical practitioner to check if anything else needs to be done to avoid any potential adverse effects